Hey guys, so I'm doing a video on this this wall texture that a homeowner requested that I put on her walls. And the reason why is because she had wallpaper on here before and she didn't like I think you kind of see it in that area. It's kind of rough. Would have required a lot of sanding, and instead she likes texture, so she asked me to mix this Homax paint texture stone finish. It's called a heavy finish. And I mixed a box of this to a gallon is what the box recommends. And I believe she got it from Lowe's. Not 100% on that. But my theory or thinking was that it was going to start sinking and stuff like that. And it's actually staying afloat in the tray pretty well. So I'm gonna do this wall here and show you guys the results. I do have on standby, I have my cut in brush and paint with no texture because I do not want, I'm gonna go as close as I can with the roller, but you're not gonna wanna probably take the paint brush and do that because it's just gonna leave a bunch of streaks when you're trying to cut in down there. So definitely do your cutting before and then come in with the roller. I am using, let's see here, if I can get this for you. Type of roller I'm using today is a semi-smooth surface, and it's called Project Select 3/8 Nap. I believe the box might even said to use a 3/8. Yes, it says to do a 3/8 nap. So I'm keeping this stick in here because I'm going to be mixing this up periodically because I want that texture to stay consistent on the wall. So I'm not going to video myself doing this, but I'm going to give you a before and after. And the ceiling's not getting it. It already has a kind of a fancy texture to it, but the walls have zero texture to it. So we're going to get started here and I'll do a walk around and let you know my thoughts. And also, you can see here, we're using Sherwin-Williams, and it's an interior acrylic latex, and let's see, I think it's, yeah, it's just a latex, I was seeing it, it's a satin, okay, that's what I was wondering. And if you're curious on the color, there it is. So, hope this video helps if you're thinking about using this Homax paint texture. I want to do a quick update. So far, not so good. I wouldn't say this is a good product, just because what's happening is it's sticking to the roller and pulling off the wall, and you can press and crush those little stones, make them flat, but it's not very consistent. And there was a spot in my current home, in my garage, where it looked like someone tried to do this. And I was kind of afraid of that. So this is the first time I'm using this myself. But what I'm going to try now is to just paint with pretty much a sponge and use it in combination. And I'm gonna update you and see how that goes. I'm probably gonna roll the paint on and then take my sponge and just go dab it. These are my findings, and I did this up high for a reason because I wasn't sure if this was going to work. It seemed like there was mixed reviews on it, but you get a big clump here. So what I'm going to do is I got this, it's a car wash sponge, and it's real fine. So what I'm doing is just going over it, and it's actually laying those real pebbles, big pebbles down, because you can see, let's see, can see like a big clump right there, and it pretty much just smashes it down. And then all right, the sponge wasn't really helping much. I mean, it does in a way. It keeps the I'll get a closer look here. It kind of keeps, like, if I get a real big clump, I can knock it down. But what I'm finding, guys, is if I paint my area and then let it dry just a little bit, I come back and these rocks, well, stones come off and stick to the paint. So just let it set up a little bit and then go back over and you'll get more results like that. And I think that's what she's going for, was like a stone texture. I'm not a huge fan of it, but from looking online, this is exactly how it looks. So yeah, I'm just doing my best to make this look presentable. It doesn't have to be, you don't want it completely dry or you're pretty much starting over, but you want it to where it looks tacky, like where, like right there is a good example where you can see some of it's dry and some of it's not. So let me see if I can find a spot here. Example, this might be a little too wet right here, but you see that where there's no stone area, just go back over it and it lays it right down. So that's how you do it. I tried a sponge and the sponge just didn't work. It was leaving weird streaks and it was pretty much grabbing the stone like the roller, and I wasn't able to roll it. I had to like wipe it and it was just making a big smear mark. So that was a fail, but yeah, work with it. You can even knock some off with your finger or just grab it with the roller, tilt it a certain way and get it to where you want it, how you like it. I would not probably recommend this product to anyone. This one was real worried about seeing flaws. I think the stone just grabs the light, and in my opinion, I don't like it, but she wanted a texture, so show you here the side here. And someone did this texture in my garage and it was the same result, real splotchy. She says she come back with a sponge though, so I'm gonna let her do that, because if not, I would just be here all day and another day trying to get this to look perfect, and I don't think it's gonna be perfect, but I'm hoping this is what she wanted. I know I saw a lot of reviews on this and was real hesitant on using this, but yeah, this is the results and this is what I saw online. So hope this helps somebody. And yeah, if you're real adamant on using it, just take your time and don't get in a rush. Yeah, on the camera, it's hard to tell, but there's more of a sandy look and it's not all dried yet. So let's see, and go back here. So yeah. Well, other side notes is this was really messy. A lot of the gravel did get, or stone got slung off, about half of it got slung off. So keep that in mind. Baseboards, I didn't take them off, but I just made sure to, I did take the baseboards off, but I made sure to wipe them down if, say, a little drop got on, because I'm gonna go back over and touch up a few spots that I had to fill. But yeah, I think the homeowner was set on this. Like I was saying, she already had it and she said she'd come back and touch things up with a sponge if she had to. She had read somewhere online about someone doing that, so she might find a better technique. I've tried everything I could do to try to get it on there thick. It probably needs more than one bag for a gallon, because it was just thin in some places. Like ideally probably want that, but even that, I don't know, I'm not real sold on that. So and she also mentioned that she could only find this stuff online, so I don't know if it's going to where they're doing away with it and it's just old stock or what. Hopefully, I think when this dries, it's gonna look a lot better. Right now the walls are still kind of shiny and dull. But yeah, here's from far away, you can see little speckles, but yeah.